with the advancements of telehealth, I have found all kinds of incredible therapists that specialize in different parts of my life. This might sound crazy, but I actually have a personal therapist. I have a couples therapist. I have a child family therapist for me and my children. And I have a family therapist for me and my broader family, like my parents and my brother, et cetera. Let me think. Do I have more therapists? I might have more therapists. Okay, but that's a lot for right now. So I have a different therapist. Oh, I have a work therapist. Yes, that's right. I have an executive coach that I call my work therapist. But, you know, the issues that you face in the office often are psychological. You know, it's how you're actually sorting out your thoughts to get things done and your behaviors. And again, I've been doing all this therapy for many years, not because I'm treating a mental health disorder of mine. I'm grateful that I don't have to deal with that, but because I think all of us could use a little bit more self-awareness of who we are. We all have issues that we're facing day to day. We live in an age of social media where we're overwhelmed with all kinds of people and personalities and world events, and it's depressing and the world's about to end every single day, and we just need a vent and we need to sort it out. And I have not spent better money than the money I've spent on therapy. I think that it is the number one thing that we can all do for our mental health, and I wish there were more therapists in this world for the demand of people who need therapists. It's one of the things that everyone in the mental health industry is trying to figure out right now, because by 2030, the number one killer in the world will not be heart disease. It will be depression and suicide and everything that comes along with that. And so again, whether or not you are plagued with one of these different types of brains, or you just need to tweak and refine your own brain and mental health, therapy is huge.